I gave this name, right? Remember? That's why we gave a different names. Actually, we need this file, VMS file, but you can just back up this whole folder. But this will be in GBs, huh? It's 17 GB. You need an external hard disk. Now it's okay, now you have only Windows 8. But later when we have Windows Server, we may have two Windows Servers or two Windows 8. Then we have this whole LAN setup. So if you lose one, then it will be very difficult to do it. Everything from the beginning. Like, what class for that? It's a problem we have. It's because the subject is like that. We need that setup. Normally, it won't get deleted, but sometimes.
I think it's the
USB na to spare ang bus na.
Yung USB yung binigay mo.
Oh.
Nawala ko na na.
So last class you are doing some VHD, virtual hard disk. See, any topic in these books will take a lot of time to finish. And if you miss something or something goes wrong, again you will have some extra time to lose. Okay, so it's not like the programming things that we learned in your previous years. They just like commands, execute, debug. So it's time-consuming process, all these things. So we are going to be very selective on these topics. Like this one, you see, we needed this file, right? First we took a lot of time for installing the ADK.
ADK, yes.
Windows Assessment and Deployment Tools. Deployment basically means installation, right? Deployment means putting deploy. Deploy means to assign things. Okay, so it's basically installation. So all the tools needed for advanced installation, that's the software. So it took a lot of time, and then we did the command. We needed this install.bin file. That's actually the ISO format of Windows. So it takes the clone of the whole operating system, and you can just put it in the virtual hard disk. But this installed, in order to make this install.vim file, you need some other softwares. That is not mentioned in the book. So the book is just a kind of reference book. Okay, they won't give you each and everything. Okay, they just give you in general. If something went wrong, you have to figure it out yourself. It's designed for professionals, not for students. So our problem was we did not have this file. So this is like the clone of the entire operating system. So what we did, we had the ISO image, right, that I gave you, of the operating system. We just extracted it, remember? You had this image. If you extract it, I think I gave you, right, last class? If you extract this, let me try. The C drive of the VMware. Okay. And VIM file is nothing but the entire image of the operating system, just like the ISO. VIM is the Windows format, ISO is the open format. Now, normally you are supposed to take a clone of an operating system and make a VIM. Like, this whole purpose of VHD is to what? Not to install the operating system every now and then, and to make software. So you make an operating system, you install everything, you make the image of that, and you take a VIM of that, and you put the VIM wherever you want, and make a VHD. Okay? Then you can put it in the USB, you can put it in any hard disk, that VHD file, you can boot from it. So it's like a portable operating system, just like Windows to Go feature. You can try the Windows to Go feature also, but you need the 32 GB hard disk minimum. The steps are there, right? You can afford one, you can write. Okay, so now I have the WIM file on the C drive, right? Now I have to do this DISM, that's a command, a tool of ADK. Now I think ADK is installed. Now see, some of the commands needs to be done using an elevated command prompt. They won't say that, but you, it's better you do it, otherwise it won't work. Elevated means, so you say, don't take command prompt from C, run. Take it from the start and you right click run as advanced. This is elevated command prompt. Otherwise it's a normal command prompt. So this command works only on elevated command prompts. So I can just give, let me see, I have C drive, that's where the WIM file is. And then I have F, which is free. Maybe I'll make the VHD on F. No, okay, I have this. Okay, I have created VHD on E drive in last class. Yes. Okay, let me try. JSON slash install.vim is my C drive, directly in my C drive. Install.vim slash index code 1 slash apply directive. My VHD is stored on E drive. I made the VHD on E drive. Yours was finished on the day?
Yeah, it's done.
It's done, right?
Yeah.
So what's next? You have to boot it, right?
Reboot. So I need to open the
PDF. You have to again do 18 step, VCD boot. F, in your case it's not F, in your case it is...
Yes, no, it's
E.
On E.
Yeah, E slash remove.
So I could conclude from a USB now?
This is the file, right?
Yeah.
This is the virtual hard disk. Now you just have to reboot, you will get the operating system.
Okay.
Now you just install on the hard disk. So you can just reboot, it will be like another packet, another boot. And all these things in the book are the first party methods, that is the methods of Microsoft. But if you see, you have a lot of third party software which are more efficient and much better than this method. So nobody uses this method. But it will work. You have something called Acronis image backup, something like that. So if you install that software, you will get lesser size images more faster. You can transport, copy more faster. But those kind of options will not be in this book. This will be only Microsoft topics.
Oh, it's
Microsoft.
It's giving me Windows 8.1 Volume 3 and Volume 2.
Yeah, that's one is from the VHD.
Oh, okay. Cool.
So now you're booting from your hard disk. Similarly, you can do the same thing on a USB. Can put, instead of that E drive, you can put the USB drive.
Just before I turn on the computer,
yeah.
I just...
So whenever you want the operating system, put the USB, it will automatically attach itself, then you boot it.
Cool.
We did it on the hard disk. Actually, it's not useful, right? Because you already have Windows 8.
Yeah.
And even if you want another operating system on the same hard disk, you can just do a dual boot. So this operation is only useful if you have a USB drive and you do it on a USB drive or some other network drive, then it is useful. But this is just to make sure how it works.
install na siya within sa VM.
Except you're doing in a VHD fashion. Normally this could probably be a USB drive. So
yeah.
If you insert the USB, you will get this option. If you don't insert the USB, you will get only this one. Very similar to Windows to Go feature. Which one is a real
it's
one?
The volume 2 is the one we've been using, and that's the recent
volume
edition.
Volume
4
is the, that's
yeah, then
the new
one.
One
we've created. Yeah.
You can even detach if you want.
Detach.
If you go to the disk management, you can right click on the create a VHD, right? You can right click and detach.
Okay.
Just like when you remove the USB, you detach the USB, right?
Yeah.
So when you do that, you right click, detach, you remove the USB.
Yes.
And you again put the USB, right click, attach, then you can reboot.
The force?
My computer.
Computers are slow here.
It's
slow.
It's sound.
How much RAM do you have here? Okay, you will upgrade the RAM to 16 GB. Still 8 GB?
8 GB for mine. That's your overall RAM.
Maybe.
I think we have requested for an upgrade.
That's it.
We created the VHD on
E
drive, right? And we forgot to attach the VHD. VHD itself is F drive. The VHD itself is F. Okay? So what we are supposed to do is, you are supposed to open this, means you are supposed to attach it. So you get F drive. F drive. And we are supposed to install the OS in the F, not in the E. The result is same. Then you will have the OSs here. Then you can, if you want the OS, you can attach it. If you don't want, you can detach it. So we just did one step, one thing wrong. Instead of F drive, we put E drive in that command. So now, right now, it's just real dual.
My computer crashed
completely, but we can just look at the fragments. a lot of setups are required. I think for this also you need a USB. But 8 GB is enough. You have to make a WinPE disk. WinPE means pre-execution and all.
Pre-execution.
Yeah. So, again, it's the same process. What you are doing here is you are going to prepare one computer for installation. So, okay, that means you install all the softwares, drivers, including the background, everything you do it. That's called reference computing. Okay, reference computer. And then you take the image of that, Vim image of that, so that you can put it in all the many other computers. You put the image on the network, and you can do a network boot. It's called Pixie boot. Remember, you can boot from CD, you can boot from hard disk, you can boot from USB. Just like that, you can also boot from a network place. Just like you can boot from DS student if you want. That means the OS will be installed. But there are some problems in this. I think this cannot be done completely without a server. You see, they are creating a shared folder and all. So let's try, but I'm not sure we will be able to finish it in this class. We may have to continue it. So you have to do it very carefully. If you do a small mistake, you have to go all the way back. First, you just go through the steps, let's see what other things they are saying. If it is not possible, we can just halt there. Create a share on the network to hold the installation files and other files related to the deployment. That's possible, right? You can create a share, you can create a folder in DS student. It's possible. Create a reference computer. So your VMware, you can use it as a reference computer. Means that's like the blueprint. Complete the software, install language, pack settings, drivers, custom wallpapers, anything you want, you do it on that computer. You take the Windows 8 computer. Prepare reference computer for imaging by removing certain values unique to the reference computer. Yeah, like a computer name. So if you are cloning this computer, reference computer, the computer will have a name, right? So my computer name is Win8A. So when you put the copy on the other computers, all computers will get the same name, Win8A, or the IP address, or there are some common things. So you have to remove the commonalities. For that you have to do the sysprep/generalize. And this is also a tool, this comes with the ADK. So you remove any general things, okay? You are making the blueprint ready, right? So you remove the general things. That you have to do. Then copy.cmd to create WinPE boot disk. Proper command line option C WinPE. You have to use OCSPNG.a. Package the WinPE files into a sector based image file. This is confusing. So this is fine. This one. So here you have to make a WinPE boot disk. For this you need a USB. A CD will also do. WinPE boot disk. For this there are some other steps that's not given here. By using this command you can make the WinPE Windows PE boot disk. Then you have to use OCSDIMGEXE to package Windows PE files into a sector based along with the proper command. And then fourth step is capture the image of a reference computer. Here you are making a WIM file of the reference computer. For this you can use the BISM command line / capture image. It's in there. Then you put the image in the network folder I have to create an answer file. Oh my god, these things are really good. Answer files are very, very complicated. You know what answer file is? Answer file means like when you do the installation, you are trying to make everything automatic. So you make the image, and you go to the other computer, you just choose the image, and you make an answer file. Answer file is like it will give you the answers for all the questions it asks during the installation, like the PC name. What else it asks?
Country,
language, date and time. Where you make an answer file. You can give many other things also. Your Wi-Fi, password, everything you can put. So it automatically takes everything. So you are making an answer file and you have to point out to that. This is not practical. It will take a lot of time. Maybe we can do some fragments of this. Okay, let's say this is your, so I'm not going to do this completely, okay? Let's try system preparation space slash generalize. Where is this Windows ADP installed?
Yung two-factor, di ba na nung last time din dito tapos nakapon siya yung YouTube?
Yung isa, ano?
Pero at least yung naman ng dami, dami email.
Ang pwede.
Try in the Windows ADK. It's not installing as a software, okay? This is Windows ADK. It's hard to find in Windows ADK. Just if you just type ADK, you just get a help file. There are no programs. You just right click on this open file location. Then you can see those tools. Sometimes you have to jiggle around these things. You have these tools, right? You have a command prompt in this, maybe you try in this command prompt. spread slash generalize. Find the way this is broke, you can just close and check. I think it's in system.32. We'll go to system.32. Go to the normal CMD. Go to the system ready to mount CDC column slash Windows slash some details. You have something called sysprep. Sysprep is a folder, okay, inside a folder, I have to get to the sysprep folder, it's there, so cd again sysprep, you have to go to this location, cd window system ready to sysprep, now you can do sysprep slash, means the path is not the map. Get this dialog box. So you get system clean apache and generalize and reboot. So you go to OOB, that is out of box experience. It will be like a fresh computer. It won't remove any data, it will just remove the details specific to that computer. That's right. It's just a part of that installation, huh? So you know that you generalize the reference computer. We are imagining that this is your reference computer. box experience. So again, you can set some general names, general. Okay. Otherwise, you won't get a chance to change all these things, right? When you buy a laptop, you see you will have some softwares already, right?
Yeah.
Like Skype and these softwares will already be installed. But still it will ask you these things.
Yeah.
That means what they have done, they have already done this. They install the softwares and they generalize. Then it's like as good as new. The softwares will be there, but still you choose to give the names and things. Stop new downloads, all the personal things will be removed.
Yeah.
So, if you want to remove any personal entries, anything, you can do this. But the data and the other drives will not be removed. The software will be intact.
Eight.